Hey everyone, I'm Jason Dean.
And I'm Colby Dane.
And this is Real Physics, where we tell you what would really happen in Hollywood production.
Because our disbelief can only be suspended so far.
Hey everybody, it's time for the Total Recall reboot.
Even though the original was a classic, the new Total Recall had a concept that was just begging to be covered.
You guys have asked for it, so we've decided to cover the fall.
Let's jump right in.
So we need to go over what the heck is happening here, since almost no one watched this movie.
Me.
The Earth is now a barren wasteland, except for Australia and Great Britain.
As social disparity is a major theme in almost all sci-fi movies, guess which place is awesome and which one sucks? That's right, Australia is basically a ghetto with kangaroos, and Great Britain is like the upper crust of Bel Air.
Now people gotta work, and a normal commute between those two places isn't too practical. So that's where the fall comes in. It's basically a tunnel through Middle Earth that ferries people back and forth, in 17 minutes no less.
One does not simply drop through Middle Earth.
Now the movie takes place in 2084, and supposedly the tunnel was completed about a decade prior to that.
Now based on that time frame, those of you who are about to graduate from college need to start applying to the tunnel digging program that should be hiring any day now. If you get started now, you and about a billion other college graduates might be able to get the project done by, say, 2074, if you're lucky.
You know, I kind of like this movie despite its poor box office reception.
Colin Farrell is not Arnold Schwarzenegger. Your argument is invalid.
Alright, so, would a big bank deposit tube through the center of the Earth even be feasible?
Well, apparently Hollywood thinks so.
Alright, well let's get to the core of the problem.
Okay, but first, a few amazing tidbits about our universe.
Number one, as you leave the surface of a sphere, gravity decreases as an inverse square function, basically varying by a constant divided by the distance between those objects. This is defined by Newton's law of universal gravitation. Now, this isn't such a big deal, except in a universe where the exponent of r could be any value millions of decimal places long, our tidy little verse decided for it to be exactly 2, which is pretty amazing. I mean, what if pi was exactly 3? That's how amazing this is.
Number 2. Now, when you do the calculus to find out how much gravitational force each lump of dirt, rock, or lava in a sphere exerts anywhere in the space around it, it turns out that it's exactly the same as if the sphere were an infinitesimally small point of mass at the center of the sphere. This is also pretty damn amazing. Why? Because despite being pulled at an angle from the mass of the Earth to your left and right, it all balances out. Not to an approximation, but exactly as if the Earth were a single point in space, so long as you are beyond the radius of the sphere.
Number 3, now here comes the real kicker, okay? Once you pass into the radius of a sphere, the 1 over r squared no longer applies. Again, you would expect the math to go south and turn into some whacked out equation since now you have mass all around of varying amounts. But no! It actually gets simpler. Now it varies linearly, like a constant times the distance to the center of the Earth.
Mind blown.
Okay, to be fair, this is just for uniform density, constant radius spheres, which the Earth is not, but the equations could have been much, much worse.
Now, the amount of time it takes for the fall is a pivotal plot point.
Don't you mean a plot hole?
Now, in the movie it's 17 minutes, but we have our doubts.
So, let's take a look at how long it would really take for the transport to reach the other side.
Now, before we state anything else, we're going to assume that this entire chasm is a vacuum.
I mean, it has to be for it to work for a variety of reasons.
All right, having said that, first we have Newton's law of gravitation. The gravitational attraction between two objects is proportional to their masses. G is just the gravitational constant, which is sort of a conversion factor. When the first mass is Earth and the second mass is substantially smaller, this simplifies to this equation, where r is the distance from the center of the Earth and m sub e is the mass of the Earth.
But when you pass below the surface of the sphere, you begin to have mass above you that pulls you up, and the equivalent gravitational force begins to get smaller. Without going into the derivation, this comes out to be this equation, where g sub a is the acceleration of gravity at the surface, r is the distance to the center of the Earth, and r sub Earth is the radius of the Earth.
Gravitational force is F equals M times G. And in our case, below the surface of the Earth, this comes out to be this equation, and then changes to this when you sub in the G sub equivalent.
Now, it just so happens that because G sub A, M sub tram, and R sub Earth are all constants, and this is a linear function, this is essentially the same as Hooke's law for springs. So, in order to find out how long it would take to get to the other side, we can use this formula for the oscillation of a spring to get the period.
Now, K in our case is equal to this equation.
Now, we plug in that equation as our variable for K, and now we can solve for the time for a full round trip. Now, the interesting thing here is the mass of the tram cancels itself out, which simplifies down to this.
Solving for this gets us a round trip time of 84.41 minutes, and a one-way trip of 42.2 minutes.
Now remember, this is for going directly through the center of the Earth, and in the movie, they clearly show a deviation to one side.
But that's not going to shave off a whole 25 minutes.
Furthermore, the movie got something terribly wrong.
Let's look at their idea of weightlessness. Everyone knows when in free fall, you will experience weightlessness. Now, during the fall, the entire trip is in free fall, and the occupants will not experience any forces in the direction of the fall.
Now, in the movie, they are weightless near the center, but have gravity everywhere else. We figured this is completely backwards.
If the tram goes through the exact center of the Earth, the occupants will not experience any force at all for the entire trip. But if the tram goes around the center, the occupants will experience a force perpendicular to their travel in the direction of the center of the Earth. Furthermore, opposite of the movie, the occupants will be able to stand on the wall to a varying degree, dependent on the distance the path deviates from the axial center of the Earth.
Now, this has important implications. This means that the tram must be guided, whether by magnets or rails which will introduce friction, impacting our 17-minute trip even further. So let's say the tunnel skirts the inner solid core. It's 1,220 kilometers in diameter. Now, going back to our equation for gravity equivalent, and plugging in 1,220 kilometers as the radius, we end up with 1.88 meters per second squared, or about 0.19 g's.
That's just a little bit more than the gravity on the moon.
Now, remember though, that's just against the side of the capsule, since there's nothing that's stopping the capsule from moving in the direction of the tube.
So not only would the trip have taken substantially longer, they got the effects on the passengers wrong too.
All right, well, let's call it.
The scene has been dismantled. This is real physics.
There you have it. Until next time, thanks for watching.
See you next week.
What do we know about the fall? Well, it comes right after sunk.
We were gonna leave this one alone, but we're gonna jump right in. That's terrible. God, that's terrible.
Come on, we made the last one work with the whole thing about spring.
No, we didn't make it work. We shit that out, like, unfortunately.
We autumn.
No!
You guys were asked for it, so we autumn cover it.
No.
Hey everybody, it's time for the Total Recall reboot.
Really?
I'm just so amusing.
Waves of humor.
That's right.
Washing over me.
Hang on, let me get some of that comedy off
whoa,
of me.
Whoa! Failure is always an option, Jason.
Failure? So, would a big box...
I like big boxes.
Yeah, I cannot lie. Oh my god.
The sphere was it. It turns out that.
2004!
In fact, did you know that vacuum has two U's next to each other?
Which is that really. Sucks.
I think that's what's so funny about the whole, like, the scene got dismantled. Right. And then I come back with, see you next week. There's a whole bunch of freaking, like, crazy shit that could go wrong in a tube running through the center of the fucking Earth. Aside from the obvious.
My bank deposit got stuck before.
Did it really?
It did.
That's fucking shitty, dude. What'd you tell us? I got money in the goddamn tube,
yes,
bitches.
I had to wait 2 hours for a company to come
that
and bring the tube apart.
That is bullshit. No, I would have just gone.
That's how you usually solve all of your dilemmas.